In this video, I'm going to react to some of the best revenge fights for teammates in the NHL. Guys, and welcome to another episode of Kabir Considers. This is the place where I react to music, media, sports, anime, anything related to popular culture. I'll watch it with an open mind and give you my 100% honest reaction to it. And if you could please hit that like button early, I'd really, really appreciate it. Now, this is going to be a lot of fun just because, and I know I say that literally most of the time these days, but I specifically pick videos from my list that I know are going to be a lot of fun to react to. Like last week, I reacted to the secret code of NHL fights, and it was really, really good for me to finally watch that because I now know, I understand why fights happen in the NHL. It's not this disorganized mess of just guys brawling. There's actually a system to it. For example, you don't pick on the star players, you don't pick on someone smaller than you, don't be a dick sort of things. And so watching this video now is I'm gonna really know why, you know, these fights happen, because I'm sure that, you know, guys have probably hit people that they shouldn't have hit. They've probably done something that they shouldn't have done that's resulted in them getting the ass kicking that they maybe shouldn't have got. So this is going to be a lot of fun to react to. So let's go. This is going to be the best revenge fights in the NHL. Let's do it.
Matt Hendricks delivered the hard hit on Aaron Ekblad. I know you've seen it. We've showed it to you a bunch of times already tonight.
All right, let's see this hit then.
And this is Matt's first game back after receiving a three-game suspension for the hit on Ekblad. He's up on the big screen right now, and they're booing him. Here's the hit. This was a hard hit.
Oh, man.
Three-game suspension. Aaron Ekblad has not played since.
Oh,
the Florida Panthers have not won since.
That was enormous.
Gaston and Thornton on the ice right now.
Yep.
Here they go.
It is Hendricks
yeah.
and Gabranson.
Immediately.
We saw this coming as Gabranson brings the right hand over time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Overhand right to
Hendricks
the goal.
Trying to keep the bigger man at bay, but it's hard as number 44 has got that right hand free. He's coming. Uppercut and then over the top.
And another rule that I learned was that when the fight hits the deck, it stopped and you do not punch the other guy when he's down. You know, I can respect that. You know, that's a fair rule. Good fight, boys. Good fight.
Matt Hendricks' fifth fight of the season.
Eric Gabranson is absolutely huge.
6'5", 216 pounds.
Good fight, boys.
Well, right side of your screen is the release by Savard, and then the
kind of
left
blindsided
shoulder.
Him there a bit.
The elbow was tucked pretty low, wasn't extended.
Yeah, the other guy did.
But that's a target head hit.
Yeah, that's uncalled for. I'm pretty sure the other guy had no clue that hit was coming. But I guess that is allowed, isn't it, right?
And how can there not even be a penalty on the play?
He's not trying to separate him from the puck there. He's trying to separate him from his consciousness.
I mean, it's well documented about hits
to
the head.
Oh, man, he's really hurt.
And you just can't tolerate them.
They're Dude, bring they've got the doctors coming ice. Out. Oh, man, he's going to get stretched out. Seeing your teammate done like that has, you know, even if it's a fair tackle, that's got to really, you know, annoy you, right? You want to get revenge for that, absolutely. I would. He's hurt, man. He's hurt. Really, really dazed.
Gets in the way of that.
We've seen Sean Cohen do that a lot, Jack. If he has no play in his
Yeah, they are going to be gunning
right
for that dude.
Thornton and Cook.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sell it right here.
So who was the perpetrator? Like, who was the guy? Was it Cook, I think, who tackled the guy just now? Let me know in the comment section. I forgot already. Oh, yeah.
A couple of lights. Thornton keeps his balance.
Helmets off.
Oh.
Oh man, he doesn't want to stop.
Gordon's ready to go again. I don't think the night's over for Mr. Cook.
The NHL is just unique, honestly, in this regard. I hope it never changes. Leave it the way it is. It's a winning formula.
Well, if you're not going to suspend him, Jack, let's go the other way. Make him play the 60 minutes tonight. And I think you're right. This is just the first of the attention Matt Cook will get here at the TD Garden. Thornton had already been on the ice. We just commenting about his play on goal to Mark Fleury, but he had his awareness about him. He saw Cook come over the boards for the line change, and immediately.
Oh, man.
Ottawa, keep it real. Is this what happens when keeping it real goes wrong?
Absolutely. And there's no question, it wasn't lost on the Ottawa Senators that Erik Karlsson, their superstar defenseman, young defenseman, was targeted in game one. Brian Boyle goes after him. Bunch of noogies to the head trying to get him off his game.
That's embarrassing, right?
It was. It was. Game two, Zenon Konopka inserted into the lineup. In the warm-up, he's having words with Brian Boyle as he circles around there to let him know.
Buzzards are closing in.
Intimidation.
Coming. Then Brian Boyle's first shift. Good clean hit by him. And then he gets attacked by Matt Kartner. Also inserted in the lineup for game two to inflict pain on Brian Boyle. And he does it in a real filthy, dirty way.
There's Boyle with the hit. And there's Kartner. He comes all the way over. And right away, there you see the punches being thrown.
Oh,
and while
man.
He's down, he's still throwing punches.
Man, he's wailing on that dude.
The Rangers have to end up with an awful long power play on this. Kartner should get 5 minutes for fighting. I'm not sure Boyle's going to get anything, to tell you the truth, unless something happened after that. But the Rangers, if they don't end up with a long power play on this, something's wrong.
Situation.
Oh, man. Oh.
Left skate.
Hold on. Did he step on his... Oh! He stepped on his ACL.
You have a little bit of an Achilles protector in the back of your boot, but if you bend your foot at all, I mean, you have to have some flex in there so you can skate.
That is malicious. That dude deserves a beating. What the heck? Dude, if he sliced his Achilles, that could be career over.
An escape blade.
In case you haven't noticed.
There's the punch.
Yeah, man.
And another punch.
Yeah, he
and
deserves
another
it.
One as he jumps on top. He just engages with Cook. Matt Cook knows it's coming right now. He just has to take three shots for Neil here.
Give it to him. Yes.
Including one
nice
pretty
left.
Good one.
Let's go back.
How the heck can you step on someone's Achilles like that? Man, that was savage.
March 8th. Many people thought that Roman Polak had hit Matt Hendricks in the wrong way. Darnell Nurse went after Roman Polak.
Give it to him, Darnell.
Penalty box. Fed it to him. Pretty big. Polak didn't even get a chance
to get
the gloves
off. Oh, man, his nose is busted.
And because he had a broken nose, he couldn't, I guess, stand up for himself today. So Michael Haley came in. You know what, Kevin? I don't care what anybody says. I understand what the game's all about. But when you bring a guy up from the minor leagues just to fight a 21-year-old kid, I think you got to re-examine your values.
You have been watching the Calgary Flames.
Fair point.
Unfortunately, drop a game to the Minnesota Wild. And now, Darnell Nurse has dropped the gloves with Michael Haley. Haley
all right.
And Nurse.
Is Haley going to be able to...
Haley.
Ooh! Haley got in two nice rights.
Roman Polak is coming across with uppercuts. Darnell Nurse trying to come back, but his sweater is tied up. Haley.
I think Darnell's getting
his
ass kicked here.
Game. This will be his sixth fight of the year.
Yeah, it was a good fight. It was a good fight.
And for Darnell Nurse.
Well done, boys.
It is the fourth time that the rookie has dropped his gloves. McDavid starts back shorthanded. McDavid going wide. Here's McDavid with a shot.
Everybody. That's Connor McDavid, right? He's one of the best players in the league, I think.
Crashes in.
That was like rule two of the secret code. Don't target star players. So somebody is going to get hurt real bad.
To the end boards, Manning. And McDavid. And Connor McDavid getting up slowly, holding his
shoulder
as he heads to the bench.
Rotator cuff.
Cuts in. Gets the chance on net.
Let's see.
Gets
here.
Taken down and slams hard with two
guys.
Flyers.
Yeah.
Going into the end boards with him. Wide drive. tries a short side shot, gets tripped, gets leveled. He's not come out for the second period. Here we go.
Maroon drops the gloves right off the face-off with Brandon Manning.
Oh, man. Maroon is
beating Manning right hand. Manning trying to come back over the top.
Ooh, the other guy's giving it to.
Jersey jab by Maroon to keep him at bay.
Oh, big overhand.
Overhand rights landing on Manning.
Yeah, it's over. Well done, Maroon.
We talked about Patrick Maroon's hats and hands that have delivered 20 goals. Well, his hands now have delivered blows to Manning, and it's his seventh fight of the year.
I love the music that they play in the background when these fights are happening. It's this move. Get out the way. Just the perfect fight music.
Brandon Manning and Patrick Maroon continue a conversation.
They're going to go again?
Manning objects to what Patrick Maroon
says. Are they going
to
go again?
And here they go.
Oh, no, this is the first fight.
Fifth fight of the year.
Well, Mark Spector was asked, and Wayne Gretzky was asked. Ooh. Boy, look at those right hands go from Patrick Maroon. The big guy at the Jersey jabs. And good for Brandon Manning for standing in. It's difficult out of his weight class, without a doubt. And this is a certain...
His head is getting bashed. Man, yeah, it was, I loved that, every bit of it. At the end of the day, if you know the rules, you know the code, if you break the code, you pay the price. You can't be, you know, taken out like the star player of a team, the guy who's responsible for getting probably most of the team's goals, and not expect repercussions. You can't, you know, try and slice someone's Achilles tendon with the blade of your hockey shoe. Like, I really, really, really hope that one was unintentional, because gosh, that looked really bad. Like, if that managed to get through, horrible. So yeah, like, I loved it. I like seeing guys stand up for their teammates, for their brethren, you know. Like, this is what it's all about. It's about being part of a greater unit, you know. Yeah, this was awesome. There's a part two. I've just seen it come up. I'm definitely going to be reacting to this one soon. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, turn on bell notifications, and keep throwing the recommendations my way. I know I say it all the time, but they genuinely help me out, because if I know you enjoyed watching something, I'll definitely enjoy reacting to it. So like, subscribe, turn on bell notifications, keep throwing the recommendations, and I'll catch you in the next one.